Oral questions by members.
The Leader of the Official Opposition.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. After 3 years of dodges, after 3 years of cover-ups, we have charges laid against a political operative connected to the Premier on her leadership team, charges of breach of trust laid by the Special Prosecutor today. There's more to come, Honourable Speaker, but this doesn't seem to be much of a surprise. We have charges against an operative in the Minister of Transportation's office just in the past number of months. We have the head of the BC Liberal Party facing breach of trust charges in another jurisdiction. We have a report from the Privacy Commissioner saying, inexplicably, that the Premier's office routinely deletes emails and disregards freedom of information and privacy laws. So in light of all of this, and in light of the revelations that more will be coming, can the Deputy Premier advise us how long he has known that BC Liberal operatives will be facing criminal charges as a result of the Quick Win scandal?
Madam Attorney.
Madam Speaker, in a case where there is an allegation against government, a special prosecutor is appointed, and in this case, a special prosecutor was appointed in August of 2013, nearly 3 years ago. His job is to advise the RCMP to assist where needed in their investigation. The reporting structure is through to the Assistant Deputy Attorney General, namely the head of the Criminal Justice Branch. And that is to keep the separation, the very important separation between government and the political process and the special prosecutor. That is the process that was followed in this case. And yes, I can confirm that there was an information sworn earlier today, and that matter is, of course, now before the court.
Leader of the Official Opposition on a supplemental.
Well, thank you, Honourable Speaker. It's just one big happy family in Liberal land. The head of the operation charged with breach of trust in Ontario. We now have operatives right beside the Premier being charged with breach of trust as a result of their activities going into the last election. We have charges against a member's assistant with respect to deleting documents about murdering and missing women. It's little wonder, Honourable Speaker, that we can't keep track. The only people we know were never under investigation were the health researchers that were fired and smeared by this government. So I guess it's good for one, but not for the other. Again, my question is to the Deputy Premier. How long has he known about criminal activity in the Premier's office?
Madam Attorney.
Madam Speaker, there is a separation, as I said a moment ago. There is a separation between the assistance that the special prosecutor gives to the police, between his then subsequent decision making. His reporting structure is through to the head of our criminal prosecutions. And as anyone who knows her will know, this is a separation that is well maintained and that everyone should have confidence in, Madam Speaker. I can confirm that as Attorney General, I get heads up on this the day before, but that information is kept to me, to myself, and to one or two others, but I don't think it was to the Deputy Premier, but it's a very close process. I gather that the critic is also informed at the same time. All of that is to keep the separation, Madam Speaker, between the special prosecutor, his line of communication only to the head of the criminal justice branch, and a complete separation from government.
Leader of the Official Opposition on a final supplemental.
Well, thank you, Honourable Speaker. And again, I can appreciate why the BC Liberals would want to separate themselves from the people that they hire, because it turns out that many of them are facing charges, whether they're here or in another jurisdiction. And I would argue, Honourable Speaker, that would be odd to the people of British Columbia who struggle every day to make a connection with this government when it comes to clawing back services, when it comes to reducing costs of housing, when it comes to meeting medical needs, when it comes to keeping schools open. Nothing from this government. But when there's an opportunity to separate the criminal activity of the people that they associate with, there's definitely a line and a distinction. Again, I'd like to engage the Deputy Premier, because I recall not that long ago, he rising in this place and saying, I'm terribly sorry for the actions of the people that the Premier collects around her. I'm wondering why he's not prepared to do that today. So through you, Honourable Speaker, again, to the Deputy Premier, you were quick to defend the indefensible 3 years ago when the acts were being done. Now that the chickens have come home to roost and charges have been laid, why nothing from the Deputy Premier?
Madam Attorney.
Madam Speaker, Speaker, I think the leader of the opposition, in using the words why we would want to keep separation, is showing a fundamental misunderstanding of the system. The system is in place in the way it is to keep that separation, to protect the integrity of the process, to protect the integrity of the special prosecution and the police investigation, so that the special prosecutor is not only free from political interference, but seen to be free from political interference. And that is absolutely an essential part of our criminal justice system, Madam Speaker. And in pretending otherwise, I think that is, as I said a moment ago, highly offensive to our system and perhaps shows just a fundamental lack of understanding as to why we have that separation. There is a clear separation. It is built into our criminal justice system, Madam Speaker, and it's an important part of our criminal justice system. And I think all of us should have confidence in that process.